Oh,
Good, good, good.
good, good.
How's the family?
Awesome. All doing good. All doing well. You said?
Yeah, all good, all good, all good. Just
Oh,
in the middle
that's
of the year.
lovely. I was, yes. No, awesome. I got some news to share. I became a granny.
Hey, congrats, congrats, congrats. Yeah,
You.
send some pics, send us some pics when you off the call.
Yes, yeah, you know, but all good things, otherwise all fine. Yeah,
No, that's good.
right.
No, that's good. That's good.
Yeah.
Babies
Yeah,
are always
so
good news.
absolutely 1 week old.
Oh, wow. Boy, girl.
Boy, boy.
Good, good.
Yeah.
There's only
So
boys in
I'm
your
going
family.
on Wednesday. Yeah, they're in Cape Town. So I'm going on Wednesday to Cape Town. So I was so glad that I was able to join in today. Because I said, I know once I'm there, it's going to be like a madhouse, but looking forward to it.
Yeah, enjoy, enjoy.
Yeah.
How's Anil? Is he happy? He's excited.
He is good. He's very excited. He's doing great. Yeah.
No, that's
He's
good.
doing
That's good.
good.
No, thanks,
Yeah.
Pamela.
Just enjoyed the first cold front we had for the year. It was just so nice.
In
Yeah.
Durban, cold front.
Yes, it was freezing. It was freezing, but it was
Yeah, because you guys got it hard because you guys are there by the beach. Closer to the beach, so it's colder.
Yes, that's right. That's right. Yes.
Yeah, no, I mean,
That's nice.
I'm in Bedlam, so I'm below road level, so it's I don't get really I don't really feel the cold.
The cold. Okay. No, we get it like really bad, but it is good. That is good. Yeah. I got a couple of catch-up sessions. I've been trying to catch up on what you've been doing. But yeah, just making some progress with my social media, but now I need to like speed it up. So I'm just glad that today I was able to make it.
No, thanks. Thanks, Bhavna. No, it's good to be here. It's good to have you here. It's good to have all of you here.
Thank you. Thank you.
Fatima, welcome, Fatima. Basha,
Good
Mala,
morning,
Pasha.
everybody.
How's it? How are you guys?
All
How's
good. Amazing.
no, you made it. Thanks, 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 thanks. Prashna, welcome. Mala, welcome. Basha, welcome.
Yeah, man, we missed you. How many breakfasts we missed together?
Yeah, no, I've been traveling, I've been busy, I've been all over the place. And I said, let's start this again. Let's start it again because it's a good way to it's also a way to motivate each other, get each other motivated and
Chat.
inspired. Yeah.
True.
Sorry, Basha, did you say something?
In today's world, yes, you do need that motivation, even though you know you kind of think you got it together, but yeah, when your one duck decides to waddle away, you need it to come back, and you
Yeah,
can't
well,
do it by yourself.
they say motivation is like bathing. So you got to bath every day. Motivation, you need motivation every day.
Yeah, especially when we see your memes and your status. Yeah, it's very, very motivational.
Yeah,
Some weird
you know
thing.
if I don't post statuses, people WhatsApp me and say, "Hey, where are you? Are you okay? Are you alive?" Because the people look forward to my status, and if I post a status in 1 minute, I'll have like 10 views. Not even 10 minutes. Like in 5 seconds, I'll have like 10 people viewed it already. It's like people are waiting to view my status. Jill, Jill Todd, are you there?
Yes, I am. Hi,
Welcome,
Sunil.
welcome.
Long
Good to
time,
see
yeah.
you. Long time. How's it going?
Same old, same old. You know, crazy, crazy, crazy. Busy, busy, busy with kids and with DSD and advocacy work. You know, that you would have seen, I think, in the media that they're cutting budgets and doing all sorts of odd things. So, yeah, we're looking at legal action.
I
So it's
see.
quite stressful. They've already cut our budget by 600,000, 2 week notice. I'm cutting it 600,000 this year. So
Shame. That's
yeah,
so sad. That's so
it's
sad.
tough times. Tough
Those
times,
it
and it's a lot of it. yeah, a lot of it's contrary to contrary to what they're supposed to be doing in terms of their strategic plans. So yeah, it's
that's
tough
sad.
Times.
That's sad because that sector is really important, you know, for do you know what I'm saying to you? What you guys do is very important.
Yeah, no, it's tough, and it's there's just no empathy. There's just no feeling for the people in the community and how it impacts. I mean, just to give a small example, they were cutting beds in children's homes, like down from 65 to 60, and the one home already had 65 kids, and they were saying from the 1st of April we're going to only fund you for. Or subsidize you for 60. It's like, well, what about the other 5 kids? It's a statutory obligation. It's a response. These are wards of the state. They've renegated on that now and changed their mind. Said, oh, no, we will, after we kind of made a bit noise about it. But they were like, no, we've got no money. That's the way it is. And we said, you can't do that. And we approached a few different sources, and eventually they just, it's always a misunderstanding. No, they'll fund those ones or they'll subsidize them until they leave. But you can't refill the spaces. So basically, there'll be no spaces for emergency care for children because they're going to just make sure the beds are all full. And what's the point of that? You've got to have emergency beds.
Okay. Yeah, you're right.
You know what I was amazed with? Julie, I don't actually know. Hi, everyone. I'm Fatima. What was amazing last night, I watched on the DAV show, was the Gauteng Province and Social Development Funding. And
yeah, same
what
thing
happened was, are you guys like part of this thing, Julie?
Yeah, I'm with KZN, and we have similar issues, and so we're working with the Gauteng group. But similar issues where they're basically they're cutting budgets, and trying to get people to sign new contracts, which basically say that if they decide they can cancel the contract. At any time without any due cause, and just give you 90 days notice, and you've no appeal process. So there's a whole lot of things that they're trying to do, and Gauteng have got similar issues. So
but
yeah, we're working closely
with Gauteng's, that little two stories that came in where that MPOs, two MPOs that were like just literally like came up in the last 2 years, they were funded in the last 2 years. 114 million rand.
What?
Two MPOs.
Yep.
I was like, what?
Exactly. Exactly.
What? Oh my God, I couldn't believe two MPOs were funded 114 million rand. And all the other MPOs now are going through this closure because, of that. And apparently you generally an MPO is not funded more than about 1 million. You actually can be funded for up to 5 million, but over a period of 5 years, perhaps 5-6 years. And for them to receive 64 and 60 million rand of funding, only two MPOs. What was happening in the background was shocking.
Money for buddies, and it's the same thing, similar thing here, where we've had a couple of years back, I remember going to a meeting where the two of the larger funded organizations, and there were 20 of the larger funded organizations in KZN were at the meeting, and we were like probably number 20, just scraped in the door. And there were two organizations there that none of us had ever heard of before, had been established less than 2 years. And the same thing, we're getting 20 million. And the rest of us, who do statutory services and on behalf of the state and the law says they must fund them, we were getting far, far less than that.
Yeah.
Well, ladies, we got to stop. Ladies,
we'll
stop this conversation. It's getting a bit fair shape now. Getting a bit fair shape, guys. Welcome everybody. Let's start the show because we only got 13 minutes of time on the show. Welcome everybody. Anybody wants to introduce themselves? Anybody wants to introduce themselves? I see Kieran is there. I see Diane is here. Welcome everybody.
Morning, Sunil. It's Kieran from Johannesburg.
Your line is bad.
Must be network, bro.
Yeah.
I'll put it in the chat.
Okay, cool. Guys, let's start. We got, today I'm doing YouTube. Today I'm doing YouTube. I've been, so since the past few weeks, I'm getting a lot of requests for YouTube. So YouTube is huge at the moment. There's a big difference between YouTube and TikTok. You got to use both the platforms, TikTok and YouTube. So the difference between TikTok and YouTube is that TikTok is short form videos. It's more for like lip syncing, dancing, and all of that. That's the videos on TikTok are between 15 seconds to 60 seconds average. But YouTube, on the other side, is long form video. It can be anything from a few seconds going on into hours. So if you're doing any training, reviews, or you're doing anything that's longer type videos, you're going to use YouTube. So today we're going to be doing YouTube, and let's start. I'm just going to mute you guys and use the chat facility, and you'll be able to connect with each other. So put your post details in chat. Fatima, Julie, put your details in the chat. Connect with each other. Guys, connect with Julie. Support her cause. She's doing a lot of good stuff for the kids and for child welfare. She's doing amazing stuff. So connect with Julie, and so let's see how we can use the social network to grow and support those people who need us. So that's why we created this platform, is to create awareness and to support each other. So thank you for being here. I appreciate it. And let's start the call. I'm going to share my screen. Just let me know if you can see my screen. Fatima, just give me a thumbs up, please, my friend. So thanks, Fatima. You know, it's exactly 5 years that we launched this. Exactly 5 years ago, we launched this social breakfast. So today we're going to be talking about YouTube, and I'm going to give you some content ideas. So this was the very first social breakfast I did. This was in March 2019. We launched this. As you can see, our biggest fan, Fatima, is there. So a little bit about this. Discover how to grow your social media during these sessions. We give a lot of gold nuggets, so invite your friends, and the more the merrier. A little bit about me, 21 years in digital marketing, having worked both on agent side and client side, internationally and locally trained, all boring stuff, but my goal is to help you achieve your goals through the timeliest and effective use of the internet. And not to brag or to boast, but to tell you that you're in good hands. Some of the clients I've been blessed to work with. So I'm sure all of you guys want clients here. The purpose you guys are setting here, you want more clients, you want more funding, you want more donations, you want more of everything. So, and you can get that on social media. So I keep on asking the same question for the past 10 years. I ask the same question: what's the most valuable currency in the world? The most valuable currency in the world is attention. I'm sure you guys saw this video that I posted the other day. I'm going to play 10 seconds of it.
Wasted days and wasted nights. I have left for you behind. For you don't belong to me. Your heart belongs to someone else. Why should I keep loving you?
If you want that video, just ask me and I'll WhatsApp that video to you. It's a very funny video. It's too funny. So the most valuable currency is attention. We need to be on our, we need to understand where our audience is hanging out. Our audience is hanging out on the mobile phone. Guess how often you use your phone every day? So we use our phone minimum 4 hours a day. We all know that our phone is an extension of our hands.
A woman was seriously injured in New Jersey when she tripped over an open cellar door and then tumbled into the basement. The 67-year-old woman. Woman was seriously injured in New Jersey when she tripped over an open cellar door and then tumbled into the basement. The 67-year-old woman was looking at her cell phone when she flipped headfirst into the basement about 6 feet below. Fire crews rescued the woman and took her to the hospital.
So just some stats for you guys. The population as we speak is 8 billion. Social media is 5 billion. That 62% of the population is on social media. 66% of the population is on the internet. That means that they're using websites and online media. So 66% is online. So that is why you need a digital strategy. This is the growth of social media over time. And social media grew by 5.6%. So the most important reason why people use social media is because to keep in touch with friends and family, can you see that? So filling spare time. So when we go onto social media as brands, we are interrupting and disturbing people online. So the time spent using social media apps, TikTok is the most used platform right now. So TikTok and YouTube. So I already went through TikTok with you. Today we're doing YouTube. And the reason is YouTube, the reason why they got such a high time is because people get lost in that, when they go into those platforms, because of those platforms are made so you spend as much time as possible. So we're doing some YouTube today. So this is YouTube, guys. This is when you go to YouTube, this is what you see. This is YouTube. As soon as you land on YouTube, you'll see on the top, you can search for videos. And then this will show what shows up in this in your feed. This is the YouTube feed. So YouTube has got the long form videos that appear first according to what you view and your viewing preferences. It will start to show you videos according to what they think that you would like. So I haven't watched these videos, but because I follow Neil Patel, I will see his video in there. And this lady, Victoria Orient, I watched a couple of her videos, so I will see her videos appear there. I also follow Janet, so I'll see Janet's stuff as well. Now, YouTube has something called Shorts, which is very similar to TikTok and Instagram Reels. So my advice to you is, when you record something on TikTok or on Reels, take it and put it onto Shorts. Right. This is the Shorts section where the videos are like using the full screen. So just to explain to you the difference between TikTok and YouTube. TikTok is a vertical layout. It uses the full screen layout. It uses your full screen. When you're watching a video on TikTok, it uses your entire screen. This is called a vertical screen. YouTube, on the other hand, is using a wide screen. So if you're going to open up YouTube, the YouTube app, you'll notice that it looks like this long thing. Like, if you want to watch this full video, you've got to turn the camera around. You've got to turn your phone around for you to view it larger. So that's the difference between YouTube and TikTok. So there's something called a channel, which you got to get a channel on TikTok. On YouTube, you got to get a channel. So the channel is quite advanced. You can put a featured video. This is the first social breakfast I did it. I assigned it as my featured video, as my intro video. You can put a profile very similar to your Facebook page. You can put a cover image. You can put a profile picture. It also allows you, what's so good about YouTube, what I like about YouTube, it allows you to put in all your social networks. So as you can see, I put a small profile of myself. I also added all my social networks in there. And then I can also create playlists, and I can also go live with YouTube. So YouTube also allows you to go live. So this is my channel. All of you guys should go and follow me. I got 89 subscribers. You guys need to follow me. So there's 10 little people on this call. By end of this day, I'm going to have 100 subscribers. Excuse me. So there's all my videos that are there. As you can see, a lot of the social breakfasts are there. And then these are the shots that I loaded. The shots, remember, as I said to you, they are vertical videos. Then if I want to go live, on the top right, there's a button called create. I can click on this create button. And if my face is in the way, just move my face or hide my face on the Zoom window. You'll see that you can, when you click on this top button on the top, you click on upload video, you click on go live, and you can click on create a post. So you can also create a post that's like an image post on YouTube now. Recently, they've launched this way, like how you get a Facebook post, you can create a post. You can go live and you can go upload a video. So if you click on upload a video, you click on upload a video. And upload a video, you get this thing here. You just select a file, you can drag a file or upload a file. So you click on select files, and I'm just going to go and find a video from my computer. A bit slow because we're also using video. Still working. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to end that. So as soon as you upload your video, you're going to choose your title. You're going to upload your title. Whatever the video is about, you're going to put the title in there. You're going to put a description, title with keywords. You're going to put a keyword rich description. You're going to choose a thumbnail. You can either upload a thumbnail or you can choose a thumbnail from the video. You can select the playlist. You can either select a playlist or you can add a new playlist. I'm just going to leave it on its own. The audience, it says, yes, it's made for children. You're going to say, no, it's not made for children. So if you say, yes, it's made for children, it's not going to play on the mini player. So I'm going to say, no, it's not made for kids. So it will play on, it'll play on all devices and people can embed it as well. So if I choose, yes, it's made for kids, then you can't really embed. They give you some restrictions if you say it's for kids. So then you've got to show more. And there's more stuff you can say. You can say that it's a paid promotion or not. I'm just going to leave everything else blank. I'm just going to say no, everything's blank. And I'm going to just leave everything default. You can add tags. You can add tags like hashtags, like social media. Right. And then I leave everything else default. In fact, this video is about me talking, so I can choose a thumbnail. Let's choose a thumbnail. I'm going to say social media made easy. And then I'm just going to click on next. At this stage, you can add subtitles. You can add end screen. So, you know, when you watch videos, you see something pop up at the end of the video to say, watch the next video. You can add it here. You can add cards. Cards are basically, you can add other related content during your video. I'm just going to leave it default. Click on next. Then it checks for any copyright and stuff. Click on next. And then visibility, you can set it as private. And let's say you're doing a private paid course. You can create a video that's private. If you just say you want to, you don't want people to find it, you can leave it unlisted. And private basically means that they need to log in using the email or something. And then public is anybody can view it. So I'm going to click on public and I'm going to set it as instant premiere. So instant premiere, what happens is it sets a timer and give them 5 minutes. And within 5 minutes, the video will play. And then you click on publish. So that's how you use your upload a video. And they give you a link. You just copy that link and you paste that link onto your social networks. You can share it on these platforms. And if I click on close, if I click on this video, it's going to allow me to. So that's what I did. I showed you how to load a video today. I showed you how to create a video. I spoke about YouTube. I showed you how to load a video. I showed you how to do a live. I spoke about shorts. I spoke about the actual video uploading. So that's what YouTube is all about. So let me do some content ideas for you really quickly. So it's not March, it's April. What happens this month? So it's actually April, Freedom Day. So all your posts should be freedom related. So some ideas to you is you can go on to Instagram and get ideas. Like this is Valentine's Day post. You can go and use the hashtag Valentine's Day. You can go and get ideas on these topics. So in April, this is what's happening in April. April, there's a lot of things happening. Just go to theteacherscorner.net and check. So in April, there's the North Pole was discovered. There's so much of stuff that's happening in April. It's International Children's Book Day. That's something maybe Julie can use because she works with kids. So there's so much of stuff that you can just go to April on the Teachers Corner and check the content to post. This day in history has also got good content. Make sure it's relevant to you, whatever you're selling or whatever your product is. This day in history. They got a lot of information of what happened on this day in history. Wikipedia is also good for ideas, what you can post on Wikipedia. Did you know, and on this day. So people are suckers for general knowledge and did you know, and you know, people are just suckers for that. Like I love what Fatima said earlier about Carte Blanche. People love Carte Blanche, even though I have never watched a single episode of Carte Blanche in my life. People are suckers for that type of information. But that's what's called reality TV. Nintendo as well. Sorry, this is also weird facts just to prove that people are suckers for general knowledge and information and motivational messages. This is an example of a motivational message. So Fatima again was telling me in the morning about how she looks forward to motivational messages and how we should be motivated, stay motivated. Rainyquote.com is a good place to get ideas. Also, if you want, go to Pinterest and get ideas. So there's something called UGC. My advice to you is all of you need to go and get UGC. UGC is where you ask your customers for content. Maybe they're using your product. An example is maybe let's use Kiran Singh. Kiran Singh is a financial advisor. His client is very happy. He sold his client an RA, and his client is super happy. And his client will give him a video testimonial to say, hey, Kiran Singh is the best financial advisor out there. Contact him. He did everything for me. He sorted out my old policies, everything. That is UGC. User-generated content is more powerful than taking out a big one-page ad in the paper. This is an example of a UGC where this couple got engaged and they posted a picture of the engagement ring on social media and they tagged the jeweler and the jeweler appreciated it. This is a bride's or a Father's Day UGC. This is a Vans Techies UGC. Some tips I can give you is use memes. Funny memes work well on social media. Stay away from controversial topics like religion, politics, racism, abortion, causes and rights. Just remain neutral. Use the daily hashtag and that's all. I'm going to open it up for you guys. You guys can ask any questions. You can unmute and ask me any questions about social media. You there? Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
Okay, cool. Any questions about YouTube? You guys need to start on YouTube. YouTube, you don't have a YouTube channel. You got to use YouTube because YouTube is big right now. YouTube is because they're getting a competition from TikTok. They're giving you a lot of reach as well. Who's got a good TikTok channel that you want to share with us?
Sunil?
Yes, yes.
Okay, I don't have a question, but I'd just like to share everything with the group. I've just launched another pizza brand that's currently online under the name Pizza, PZA, and it's a sourdough-based pizza. So please support me currently on Mr. D and Uber until we find a store. So it's Pizza, PZA.
Put in the chat.
I will do that. Thank you.
Congrats, Bhavna.
Thank you.
Okay. Hi, everybody. My name is Tashima. I have a question, Sunil, with regards to YouTube. I have previously loaded onto the YouTube channel, onto my YouTube channel. However, just a quick question. When you're extracting the link from YouTube, especially when it has the word shorts there, I think it says, you know, at the end of the link, it says shorts. Now, certain links like that, you have to convert it into something else, another link, in order for you to take it and put it onto like a website. For example, you can't take that link video and put it onto a website. Do you know how to do that conversion?
No. So did you use your phone to upload or did you use your computer?
Everything happens on my phone.
Yeah, so maybe what you got to do is maybe use your computer. I think that's the reason because you're using your phone.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, because I do a video like this, like I record like this, and then when I upload onto YouTube, it will go through there, but when I'm copying the link to post it into you know, like a website, it doesn't like convert to the website, you know, channel to play. It actually, it doesn't do anything. So I know I have to change something in that word shorts to TV watch or something. I know that's another thing that, so maybe we just need to follow up on something like that just to have an idea on how to convert it.
Yeah, I know. I think it's definitely because it's on your phone. Huh? I think it's definitely because it's on your phone. Okay. Because I just uploaded this one now. I'll show it to you. I just uploaded this one now. There's no shorts on it. It's actually a short. It's a short as well. I'm going to show it to you. Do it in a computer. Remember what I said to you the other day when I first started? You can't climb the ladder of success with your hands in your pocket. Remember? So you got to use your laptop. Can you see that? I just uploaded this now. It's a short. It is a short.
Yeah.
And it is, yes, because I used the computer, it came up with the full name.
Link. Okay. All right. Okay.
Yeah. Cool. So guys, please go and follow my YouTube. Subscribe to my channel, please. I want to go to 100 by the end of this day. And there are 10 people online.
Please post your link in the group.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
Not in this group, in the main group.
Yeah, you're right. Any more questions? Any guys? Any questions about YouTube? You guys want to ask you about YouTube? Please, my homework for you is for you to go onto YouTube today. You got to start using YouTube today.
Okay, another question. I did ask you about followers on TikTok. That was a personal question that I asked you. Maybe we can just share with the group before you go with regards to how do we get followers? I mean, you just go randomly and follow people, or how do you get followers? Because I think I got more likes than followers.
Wait, on TikTok?
On TikTok.
Yeah, you got to follow people. You got to follow people. You got to engage with people. You got to follow people. You got to engage people. You got to post content that people... You also got to post content that is engaging. People want content. You don't want content... you don't want to... people are going to follow if they don't see you. So if, number one rule is you got to create content and you got to use the right hashtags as well. If you use the right hashtags, people are going to see your content. If you use the right hashtags, people who follow those hashtags will see your post in the For You page, and then they will follow you. And also what's important is in your actual captions, you must say, guys, follow me. You must say to them in your video, guys, follow me. So people will follow you.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
Okay,
you don't have if you don't have people to do something, they won't take action. That's why it's called call to action.
follow me. I never thought I'm a Sheldon P to follow me. I thought they will just automatically follow me. Yeah, my one post I received like 1,600 views.
That's good. That's good.
So
Well done.
I was like, wow. Yeah,
That's
cool.
good.
Thank you
That's good.
much.
That's good. Cool, guys. I will see you guys next week, Monday, at the same time, and have a great week. And I will catch you guys soon. Follow me on YouTube. Thank you so much. I already got one subscriber who subscribed to me. It is Mr. Kieran Singh. Thank you. Kieran is mine. Kieran's gonna get a gold
I
star
think I
soon.
already did, hey?
Yeah, cool. Thank you guys. Thank you everybody. See you guys next week
Great,
Monday
cheers.
and go back and watch the recording
Thank
on
you.
YouTube.
Bye. Take care.
Bye. Bye. Thank you guys. Thank you everyone.